From priceless pieces of history to artifacts of religious significance, here are 10 most valuable lost treasures that no one can find. Number 8. Lexicon Medicum Universale. In the 18th century, there was a French scholar by the name of Louis de Jaucourt. He was a prolific writer, one who had spent 20 years of his life working on a 6-volume medical dictionary called the Lexicon Medicum Universale. After the volumes were completely done, he went and shipped the books to his publisher, who happened to live in Amsterdam. Jaucourt did this because he wanted to get the books out of the country and publish it elsewhere due to the French's belief in censorship. A problem occurred, though, as the ship carrying his books sunk off the coast of Holland, thus destroying a priceless piece of knowledge that could have benefited the world upon its release. The only blessing that Jaucourt got from the ordeal was that he was soon asked by none other than Denis Diderot to help contribute to his publication piece called the Encyclopedia. Not only did Jaucourt do so, he used the notes that he had made for the Lexicon Medicum Universale to help make the entries. Jaucourt made 40,000 entries in the encyclopedia, which later became one of the most important pieces of the Enlightenment. Should his medical dictionary have survived, the worth on the piece would have been astronomical due to Jaucourt's new fame. Number 7. The Amber Room. History has shown us that there are many great things that can be built should a person want them to, including an entire room being constructed out of amber. This occurred in 1701, where it was constructed in Berlin City Palace before eventually being given to the Prussian King Frederick William I, to his then ally, Peter the Great of the Russian Empire. Once it was brought to Russia, it was installed in the Catherine Palace. After expansion and several renovations, it covered more than 55 square meters and contained over 6 tons of amber. Try and imagine walking into a room and seeing all of that amber. It would have been something to behold. Which was proven when the whole place was looted by a group of German forces in World War II, part of their desire to steal and sell the priceless works of art in Asia for their own gains. At first, it was put at Königsberg for reconstruction and display, but now, no one knows where it is. A reconstruction of the Amber Room is now in Russia after many decades of work. Many stories and theories have been put out about what really happened to the Amber Room, but no definitive proof has ever been given that it was in one place or another, or that the amber of the room itself wasn't stripped and sold or destroyed. Number 6. The Spanish Treasure Fleet. The year was 1712, and in Spain, the people had just won a war for their succession, a brutal war that enveloped much of Europe, including the French and the British, as well as other allies. By the time the war was over, Spain was declared independent of British and French influences, and so they were able to continue their ways. However, because of the cost of the war, the Spanish needed to refill their reserves. Knowing that they had assets in the New World, in this case Cuba, they sent a fleet of ships to go down there, take the treasures that they had acquired, and bring them back to Spain. By the time 1750 had come around, the fleet was 11 ships strong and full of various items of wealth, including gold, silver, and pearls. They were to set out for Spain soon, except the leader of the fleet made a very foolish decision. He decided to wait until an inopportune time to set sail, hurricane season. Over the course of a week, the entire fleet was sunk. Not a single ship survived. Thousands lost their lives, and all the treasure sank deep down into the ocean. Fast forward to today, in what we know as Florida, and there's a stretch of land called the Treasure Coast, because occasionally a piece of gold, silver, pearls, or other items will wash up from the treasure fleet reserves. Many pieces have been found over the years, and yet it's only a pittance of what is said to be out there. Not to mention that there are 4 ships in the fleet that have not yet been found, one of which was called San Miguel, is said to have $2 billion worth of items on board, and this was meant to be one of the lighter ships in the fleet. So who knows how much the other 3 ships could have if they are found. Number 5. The Holy Grail. There are many different interpretations of the Holy Grail across literature and pop culture. The original findings of the phrase Holy Grail is linked not to the Christian Bible, but to the Arthurian legends, even going by the name Lancelot Grail. At one point, it was destined for his son, Galahad. However, arguably, the most important version is that of Jesus Christ, who is said to have used a certain cup or grail to allow his disciples to drink his blood at the Last Supper. Where the cup went from there is a bit of a mystery, including some saying that the Roman Empire took it and delivered it to a saint. Since that point, the quest of the Holy Grail began. Whether it was for the Arthurian legend or the legend of Christ, people searched for it. Most believe that he who drinks from the cup will get immortal life, or special powers, depending on the interpretation. The cup was the focus of many stories in movies and television, including Indiana Jones and the Last Crusade. Number 4. Atlantis. If you think about how much Atlantis is ingrained in our culture, you would think it's a real place. One of the greatest philosophers of all time, Plato, actually wrote about Atlantis in Timaeus and Critias, further helping cement its place in history, real or not. According to Plato, Atlantis was an advanced civilization, but one that made the mistake of trying to take down Athens. Athens would respond with deadly force, and even the gods of the Greek got involved and sank Atlantis to the body of the ocean, where it still remains to this day. So technically speaking, it's a legend, one that many feel Plato wrote about as to be a warning to certain civilizations. But what if it wasn't just a story or a legend? What if it was real? This is why many people have searched for Atlantis over the years. Because this lost city is said to have been a utopia of sorts, and it could solve many mysteries of the ancient world. Number 3. Imperial Fabergé Eggs. The phrase Fabergé egg has meant many different things over the years, but the pinnacle of them were the Imperial Fabergé eggs that were made by Peter Carl Fabergé at the behest of the Russian royal family. He was even ordained as a goldsmith by special appointment to the imperial crown. The eggs that he made weren't just full of precious metals and items like gold and diamonds, but they were beautifully crafted by the request of the crown. Each one was not only unique, but had a surprise in them. This was to help bring even more joy to the imperial family who had them. The fame of the eggs got even more commissioned order for them, and it's said that about 50 of them were made for the Russian royal family. However, after the Bolshevik rebellion and the fall of the Romanovs, the imperial eggs were stopped in their construction. The eggs themselves were scattered, sold, or lost. Many of them have been found and put on display in museums or in private collections. One was even found in 2015 by an average guy who almost scrapped the egg for parts. The rest of the eggs, though, are still missing, which is a great mystery. Were they destroyed over time? Are they being hoarded by people who don't know what they have? No one knows, and no one is sure if the entire collection will ever truly be found. But should another egg pop up, that egg, depending on its quality, can expect to be sold for tens of millions of dollars. Number 2. Flor de la Mar. The Flor de la Mar was a ship made by the Portuguese in 1502, and by the time 1511 had come around, it was not only one of the best galleons in the world, it was the pride of the Portuguese fleet, which is why after it helped capture the city of Malacca in Malaysia, the captain of the ship, Afonso de Albuquerque, decided to load up the Flor de la Mar with all the treasures that he had taken from their conquest. The intent was to take the ship back to India, where they had a presence at the time. And the ship was filled to the brim with gold, silver, priceless jewels, and much more. The captains of the Portuguese fleet warned Albuquerque against setting sail, but he didn't listen to them. So as they were going through the Strait of Malacca, a violent storm emerged and it tore the ship in two, and the contents of the ship were carried off by the violent waters. The ship and its contents are still lost, and many consider it one of the greatest treasures yet to be found. Number 1. Ark of the Covenant. Arguably, one of the most famous artifacts of all time, the Ark of the Covenant, is said to be a thing of great power. But not from the people who have seen it personally in the modern day, but rather from the Bible that describes it in great detail. The Ark of the Covenant was covered on all sides with gold, in which was a golden jar holding the manna, and Aaron's rod which was budded, and the Tablets of the Covenant. The Tablets of the Covenant is another name for the Ten Commandments that Moses brought from the Mount Sinai in the book of Exodus. What's important to note here is that this relic was one of the most important things in Jewish culture at the time. The Ark of the Covenant was moved around during the times of battle as a symbol of God being with the people, yet they were always careful about where it was placed, who saw it, and more. It was stated that God himself was within the ark and that those who weren't worthy of touching it would suffer, such as is in the Bible when the ark was slipping from its apparatus and the Jews used to move it. A man reached out and touched the ark to put it back into place and died on the spot. Azazel reached out and took hold of the ark of God because the oxen had stumbled. And the anger of the Lord burned against Azazel, and God struck him down on the spot for his irreverence, and he died there beside the ark of God. 2 Samuel chapter 6, verses 6 through 7. The mystery of this item, though, is its current location. Many historians and archaeologists do believe that the Ark of the Covenant did exist at one time, but where it is now? No one knows. Looking through history, there are places many suspect it could have ended up, such as Babylon when they conquered and assimilated Israel, or that it could have been lost when the first temple was destroyed, and others still think that the Jews buried it somewhere in order to keep it out of enemy hands. No one is certain where the sacred treasure is, which is why it has become a popular item to talk about in pop culture, and the mystery of its location and its powers grow with each generation of storytellers. Thanks for watching! What did you think of these lost treasures that haven't been found? Let me know in the comments below. Be sure to subscribe, and I'll see you next time. Bye!